One of the things that I think is the difference between an ecclesia and a lot of people just doing their best for God, there's just very much a direction. There's a we're going somewhere, not just we're trying to obey God till he comes and gets us.
I mean, I know you can have a bunch of people together that are devoted to Jesus and love him and care about what he cares about, but it's nothing like a lampstand, a church where there are the gifts.
Seeing the difference between a group of people,
the whole steeple and the people and all that stuff,
and a people.
It was open up and here's the people, and God is wanting a people. And that there's a pretty big distinction with a bunch of people versus a people.
That have purpose, have direction, have leadership, gifts, and help to really be purposeful and to be a lampstand.
That scripture that says Jesus walks amongst the lampstands, I think that's a really good picture of church because he wants to make his home in the lampstands, in the churches. And so he gives the Ephesians 4 gifts of apostle, prophet, evangelist, shepherd, teacher. He gives those gifts so that there can be peace, so there can be unity, so that there can be seeing and discernment and healing. And we can't do that without those gifts. People just can't do that by themselves. People fight, people are blind, people are stupid.
Without it, things are just kind of can be dead and flat, and things can happen where people didn't see a certain situation as being wrong, or people can be misled of how things should look.
I think without the gifts that I've been surrounded with, I guess I would feel directionless in some ways with good intentions, which isn't going to bear a lot of fruit.
There can't be a city set on a hill that's shining without those gifts, and without it, it's just people going each and every way, going whatever they think's best.
And so Jesus puts those gifts there so that those things can all be worked out.
Making sure that the building is secure, that it's not built on something less than Jesus.
Pointing us and pulling us and drawing us towards Jesus and his ways.
I had a lot of people around me caring for me, loving on me every day.
It's not that it starts off perfectly. There's a lot of things to work through, a lot of sin, a lot of immaturity, a lot of blindness, and those gifts give a way through so that he can be high and lifted up.
There's answers. There's a way that emerges. There's a path forward when I don't know the path.
You can clearly see the difference once you've seen what those gifts look like among the body of Christ, people who have the gifts of seeing what God's heart is in that specific area and being able to, you know, chime in and raise the vision of people, and people who aren't afraid of saying the difficult thing.
The gifts are very, very obvious.
There's something about gifts that only the person with the gift can do, that nobody else can do what they're given to do.
It is something just from God, and it's his supply and his provision. That's not because someone deserves it or who they are as a person, but only because of his grace, God's grace and mercy and kindness to the rest of his people too.
But it is something that God gives that nobody takes it.
And that it is unto giving to others. It's not for the person themselves. You know, it's a costly thing too, to give that gift out.
Gifts are expressed in his people, but no one has titles. You don't hear pastor so-and-so, leader so-and-so, so-and-so the encouragers.
The gifts are unto edifying the body of Christ as a whole, not this kind of, I have some talent and therefore I should lead.
It seems like God's looking for those who are selfless, who are obedient to him and will say what he's thinking, what he wants them to say, and not just what's easy or self-promoting.
We need help. We need the direction that God provides through a leader. But that comes in a way that's oftentimes not very visible.
Light isn't necessarily telling you go here or do this. It's just illuminating a path. It's illuminating something else that you couldn't see otherwise. So I get to see the Jesus in other people's lives.
Over us in the Lord, but there's no title, no, the children run to them. You know, we love them. They're not foreign to us. They're servants of all. I mean, the ones that I think of in my mind, they're the ones who've given the most.
I've been surprised about how much I can kind of see the load. Not that they wear it heavily or show it. I just know that they do a ton to help from a spiritual standpoint. And then on top of that, they're serving. They're down on their hands and knees scrubbing something. They are taking people from this place to that place. They're, you know, taking a child to its doctor's appointment or something like that. They're serving beyond their responsibility.
You know, Paul not looking for his own glory, but willing to suffer many times and to keep going. You know, he talks about how many times he was shipwrecked, how many times he was beaten or stoned, but he didn't stop because of that. He didn't let down or start speaking something that seemed less scandalous.
Having a pure life before God that you lay down and help other people to do the same.
Leading by example.
Like Paul, you know, definitely a man with a great gift. He lived a life that said, imitate me.
That example has caused me to reconsider what I would do, or even just to grow. Maybe it wasn't a big thing of, I was gonna do this, but now I'm gonna do that instead. It's more of just, okay, wow, that I like that way of life.
I've seen that this person has borne fruit. And I can even testify in my own heart that what they say about God, it'll cut me right to the heart. It's undeniable.
I don't have to try to prove the wisdom and the leadership that I that I receive, because it resonates in my heart and it resonates with what I know of God's word, and I don't have to try to prove it. It's like
the Jesus in me just says yes.
My mind recalls things without me even trying to say, yes, God said that. Yeah, God, it's written that that's the way it ought to be. That totally lines up with God's heart. And
the sheep know the shepherd's voice. That's the shepherd's voice. You're leading me to Jesus.
The other way you could know whether leadership is really good leadership, whether it's really from God, is the fruit that it bears.
They have authority from God based off of the fruit of their lives.
Whether a certain person has borne the fruit of changing people's lives around them, helping people who were weak and immature to know God and to look more like Jesus. And if I've seen someone who's helped another person rise like that, there's a sort of trust that, hey, they can probably help me too. They can help me go higher.
People with the gift of leadership have a level of investment and care in God's lambs that you don't see necessarily in everyone else. Other people might be loving the person next to them, but the people with that gift can see into people's hearts and help on a different level.
Just seeing a bigger picture than maybe others can see.
God gives a special help and a special push and a special seeing that can take somebody who's floundering or is insecure or is just young in Jesus and say, come this way, look at this, what about this angle?
Angles and things that you wouldn't have even been able to know were there.
And it's like, how did you know that that's what I was thinking?
We didn't know what wisdom was, and God gives a gift.
Hitting the nail on the head with the response of exactly what I was wondering or what I was asking about.
Just yes to things they say.
There are certain people who, like, I feel like every word that comes out of their mouth is like gold. You're like, oh, that's crazy.
Like when I ask them a question or something, or we're talking about something, the answer is pretty different from what I expected, you know, sort of different. And yet it's like, oh, yes.
It always goes deeper than, oh, that was the right answer. That's good.
And it's like, yeah, that was right on. That wasn't just words.
It's anointing. I mean, it really is. That's not a fairy tale. It's real.
The insight that they've had into my specific situations has been nothing short of life-changing.
So I don't get to choose how that authority comes to me. You know, I'd rather you say that nicer. Or, you know, if you did it this way, that would be better.
God's power is on this person in this way, and there's a weight to it, and then there's also a testimony afterward that it was the truth.
And I've seen a lot of growth and change in people because they asked one question.
I've just seen how those gifts, the Ephesians 4 gifts, are so necessary for supernatural life.
Honestly, I wouldn't even know what God's will was. I mean, you know, there would just be kind of this desire to go in the right direction, but I wouldn't know where I was going without the gifts of leadership and care and the formation of something where I was part of what God was doing on a bigger scale than just my own personal life, that He wants the church.
Inspiration of, this is where we're going, folks. Come, come, this is where we're going.
It's going to a place that none of us have ever been.
Just a demonstration of God is going to have a church. There is power in what God's doing here.
There's something of God and something of heaven. I was thinking about this morning about Genesis when he talks about God's spirit over the void, hovering over the waters. And it feels that, like that, that's kind of what happens for a church, that God's spirit hovers over people who really care, and God does something because we cannot pull this off.
And it was just striking to me that I have never heard, and you know, growing up, I've never heard anything about budgets or strategic plans or sermon topics or any of those things that are pretty much across the board associated with leadership in the religious world. I mean, how do you be a pastor or a head pastor or even a deacon or an elder without somehow touching a schedule or a budget or a strategic plan or an outreach program? I've never heard of any of those things in the life, and yet there is fruit. You know, people's lives are changed.
You can tell it's right because I have seen lives changed.
There's something inexplainable there that I know is so important, and that we couldn't have a functioning ecclesia without it.
There's just no way that we would be the people together that we are apart from the gifts. It just wouldn't happen.
The quality of the leadership has produced individuals, and not just individuals, but have produced a body that really reflects Jesus.
It's just God's goodness and his, you know, his own honor. He's after something.